elasticity of supply. A change in price brings out a change in quantity supplied. It means that quantity supplied is responsive to change in price. The concept elasticity of supply measures the responsiveness of change in quantity supplied to a given change in price. In measuring the responsiveness, we have to take into account the change in price on the one hand and change in quantity on the other. Normally, we do not take into account the absolute change in price and compare it with absolute change in quantity supplied. But why? Because it will lead us to a wrong conclusion. How? Look at the supply schedule. As the price goes up from 10 rupees to 15 rupees, the quantity expands from 50 units to 60 units. Price changes by 5 rupees, quantity increases by 10 units. It is quite obvious that change in price is less than the change in quantity. This will make us to conclude that a small increase in price causes a big increase in quantity. This is a wrong conclusion. The fact is, the price change is larger than change in quantity. How? Compare the percentage changes of both in price and quantity. First, take the percentage change in price. Change in price divided by original price into 100. 15 minus 10 divided by 10 into 100. 5 by 10 multiplied by 100 equal to 50%. Then take the percentage change in quantity. Change in quantity divided by original quantity multiplied by 100. 60 minus 50 divided by 50 multiplied by 100. 10 divided by 50 multiplied by 100 equal to 20%. Change in price is 50%. Change in quantity is only 20%. Now compare. A large increase in price brings out a small expansion in supply. The correct decision is, a given percentage change in price, that is 50%, causes a less than proportionate increase in quantity supplied, that is 20%. This is the correct way of comparing the two changes. Hence, elasticity of supply can also be defined as the percentage change in quantity supplied to a percentage change in price. What we have to understand from the concept of elasticity of supply are: 1. It measures the responsiveness or sensitiveness of quantity to a given change in price. 2. It tries to assign a numerical value to it. For example, in the present case, the elasticity is 0.4. It is arrived at by dividing the percentage change in quantity supplied with percentage change in price. That is 20% divided by 50% equal to 0.4. 3. Based on such values, it identifies 5 types of elasticities. Well, what are they? Wait. More about elasticity of supply in the next lesson.